This is WSUR and I am Crazy G and you're locked into the G spot. And let's see, let's find out who we had there. We had Boba Flex, Never Coming Back, and we kicked it off with Avenged Sevenfold, Coming Home. And in between, we had a band called Lord Dying, and something new off of their newest release, let me see here, Summon the Faithless. And that song was actually the self-titled track, Summoning the Faithless. And we're going to go to the phones right now because we have Eric, guitarist and vocalist for the band Lord Dying, on the other end. You there, Eric?
Yeah, I'm here.
I want to thank you for taking the time to hit the G-spot. What's new and how goes it?
Oh, shit, man. We've been on the road a lot, trying to play as much possible. We just got back from Europe. Now we're doing a U.S. tour. Then we go to Europe again in March. And, just looking out there, playing as many shows as we can.
For those who don't know who Lord Dying is, can you share some info about the band and how it got going?
Yeah, we're a metal band out of Portland, Oregon. It started back in 2010, but really it started a lot longer before that. Me and the guitar player have been playing in bands for a long time, probably 15 years or so, but this one's been going about 3 years. And lots happened really fast in those past 3 years, and out there playing as much as possible.
Your brutality definitely shows on your most recent release, Summon the Faithless. It's punishing and explosive. What went into this CD?
That was kind of a culmination of all the songs we wrote over the past few years. They weren't really necessarily intended to be on one album. The next one, however, definitely more centered around that. That'll be out in the fall. But, they're just songs we've been working on and playing around. And, we got kind of lucky and realized picked this up and been touring a lot ever since.
Well, it's an incredible CD, I got to tell you that right now. The first track, and I love all the names to every track, by the way, In a Frightful State of Not Dismemberment, and I just played that not too long ago. It's ruthless. Was that the band's intention with this song opening on the CD?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, yeah, it's really brutal. It's also kind of a love song, too.
Really?
But, it's kind of about being left hopeless and nothing left but a savage, you know?
The whole CD is savage, and Summoning the Faithless, the self-titled track, is merciless. Where did the idea come from for this track?
Well, the songs are all kind of written basically just around the riffs, and then everything else, like the lyrics and the titles, come in later. But I don't know. It just kind of came together. None of us, we're definitely out of like a strong opposition towards religion and against religion of any organized sort. And kind of, you know, a personal track to me. So, yeah, I guess that's how that kind of came out.
I don't think there was one track on this CD I did not like. Another vicious track, Greed Is Your Horse, is absolutely chaotic. What was it like writing that song?
That one had lots of different styles, I would say. It's one of the most brutal ones on there, I think. It was pretty chaotic. It's kind of a long song, and it's a long process on writing it. But, we're happy with how it turned out.
This whole CD is ferocious. Did it come out exactly the way you guys wanted it to? And are there any cool stories you could share from the making of this CD?
It definitely turned out how we wanted it. We recorded with Tamper Parker, a guy we always wanted to work with. And he's done a lot of doom metal and sledge records. It turned out really heavy. It was a fun process. As far as funny stories go, there was several times where a bass player kept getting locked outside of the recording studio on this little patio, go out there to smoke some weed and kind of forget about it. where's Don?
That is funny. Oh, man. As you said, you guys hail from Portland, Oregon, and you've been doing this for a handful of years now. What has the ride been like to this point for you guys?
Oh, it's been a lot more than we ever expected, man. It's been really great, and we just keep getting more and more opportunities. We're just gonna ride it until it stops.
Hopefully, it doesn't stop, and nobody ever gets off.
Yeah.
I am curious to know who are some of your or the band's musical influences.
We all love Slayer. We all love bands from the Pacific Northwest, like the Melvins and Carp. But we all definitely have a strong metal background of influences. So, yeah.
You're on tour right now with Vaporizer and Modern Voice. What is it like playing live, and what can the fans expect from that show?
They can expect to have a good time. It's going to be brutal. It's going to be super loud. And hopefully everybody loses a pretty serious hangover.
Well, I'm going to try to make it, but I don't want no serious hangover. Maybe from the music.
Yeah.
Speaking of the fans, is there anything you want to say to them?
Hell yeah, man. Thanks for all the support. And we'll just keep doing it as long as people want to keep hearing it.
I like it, and I can't wait to hear some more stuff from you guys. The whole CD, as I said earlier, is phenomenal. Punches you right in the face, and that's what I like. I like something that gets the blood boiling. You guys have done it, as far as I'm concerned. Are there any plans to get right back at the writing process, or has that already begun? And what is next after the tour for Lord Dying?
Yeah, we actually, right after we get back from Europe, we've got a whole other album written, and it's we're going to start recording it right when we get back, and it should be out in the fall.
Awesome. Is there any tidbits you could possibly share with us, or is that all, you know, locked up?
It's pretty behind the scenes, but I'd say I can say it's going to be more cohesive, and it's going to be way more brutal, a lot angrier than the last one. So
this one was pretty angry, let me tell you, and I loved it. I want to thank you. I want to thank the band. I want to thank New England Concert Reviews. I've taken up enough of your time. I know you're very busy, and I appreciate it. The station appreciates it. I wish you the best. Hopefully, we will talk to you again soon.
Hell yeah, man. Thanks.
No problem. Have a good one, man.
You too. Later.
That was Eric Olson, guitarist and vocalist for the band Lord Dying. Right now, I'm going to play another track off their most recent release, Summon the Faithless. This is Greed Is Your Horse, right here on WSUR.